In this workshop, we'll be setting in the sixth and final set of flowers in the floral yoke. We'll be working with yarn G, and there's just one round. The distance between these flowers after setting in and measured between the tips of the edge petals should be 9.4 centimetres. And the outer circumference, again measured around the tips of the edge petals, should be 150 centimetres. I'm using a 2.75 millimeter hook and yarn G. I've also got a double pointed needle. You might find that helpful to get in to some of these double crochet stitches, which are going to be a little bit tight. So I'm going to start between any two petals, working right down into the double crochet on round one. So this is where your double pointed needle might come in handy, or something similar. So we'll join our yarn, work one chain and a double crochet. So that's a double crochet spike stitch. And then two chains and a slip stitch into the top of that petal. And so we're going to go right in to the top of the stitch, and ideally we're going to pick up two threads like this. So that's just going to give a firmer join. So that's a slip stitch, two chains, and then back down into round one. With a spike stitch. Two chains. And now we're ready to join. So we just want to position this in the right place. So these two chains are going to join at a halfway point around this curve of the petal. If you look at the stitch diagram, you'll see in green, I've indicated the stitch where ideally it should be joined, but actually I tend to just do this by eye. So I'm going into a halfway point. I'm not too concerned about counting my stitches, but if you want to count, then check the stitch diagram. So draw that chain stitch through, two chains, then back down into that same double crochet with a double crochet spike stitch, and then two chains, slip stitch into the top of the next petal, again ideally picking up two threads. So that's a slip stitch, then one chain, and then we're joining here. There's two double crochets here, one either side of that kind of, I call it a corner, it's not technically a corner, but I'm going into the second double crochet in that point. So we'll draw our working stitch through, and then it's a slip stitch back into the top of that petal. Two chains, double crochet into round one. So that's a double crochet spike, one chain, And now we're joining at a halfway point around this curve. Again, check the stitch diagram if you want to see exactly what which stitch to go into. I tend to just work by eye, and I'm going in here. Draw that chain stitch through, one chain, and then a second double crochet spike back down into round one. Two chains, slip stitch into the top of the next petal. One chain, and then we're joining into the middle stitch. Draw that working chain through, slip stitch back into the top of that petal. Two chains, double crochet spike down into round one. One chain. I'm just going to maneuver my work around. And then I'm joining into a halfway point around this petal. Draw the working stitch through. One chain. Second double crochet spike. Two chains. Slip stitch into the tip of the next petal. One chain. And then we're joining at this point here. So the first double crochet of that little corner. Draw the working stitch through. Slip stitch back into the tip of that petal, two chains, double crochet spike, two chains, and then we're joining around this curve. Again, check the stitch diagram if you're not entirely sure where to go. If not, just judge it by eye like I do. Two chains, slip stitch into the top of the next petal. Two chains, two double crochet spikes. Two chains, slip stitch into the tip of that last petal. Double crochet spike back into that first stitch down here. It's getting a little bit tight in there. And then we can do a slip stitch join. I'm doing my slip stitch join into my first double crochet because that feels easiest. You might need to just play with those petals so they sit nicely.